signified unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but rather to recommend discreetly and even in the fear of God. Into this holy state these two persons come now to be joined. And I want you to know who gives this man to this woman. You do? I hold in my hand two rings, circular in nature, platinum and diamond. Is that correct? Or
silver? Reverend Johnson got
you. Amen. Lace and diamonds. And they are a symbol, an outward symbol of a union that is eternal in this life and even in the life to come. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this symbol, this token, which these two shall yet exchange. Let it be a shining reminder of the commitment made here today. Bless them and keep them, protect them and provide them. In the matchless name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Bride and groom have their own vows that they like to share to each other at this time. Ladies first. You are loving, kind, brave, and consistent. I know that a blessing like you in my life is not because of the goodness I've done, it's because of the goodness of God. I promise to never take you for granted. I promise to be strong in areas where you are weak and to be supportive while you dream. Today, before God, I
to strive to be that man nevertheless each and every day. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to love and support you, to attempt to see your perspectives and respect your opinions. Even when I don't understand you. I promise to always learn from you. And as we grow together, to acknowledge you and thank you for shaping and molding my character. I promise to listen when you are in need of an ear. I promise to provide a shoulder when you are ready to shed some tears. I promise that I will always be truthful and forthcoming with you and put the needs of us before the needs of my own. I promise to protect you and pray for you, just as that little child did so long ago and always has. This is my promise to you.
Amen.
Once dead, now resurrected Savior, who is Christ the Lord. that promises to be with them all the days of their life. You don't have to worry about who's looking behind Larry and our sheep. It's two angels, goodness and mercy.
Amen. Amen.
All the days of their life. In almost 20 years of marriage, I can attest that the storms of life may rage, the winds of turmoil may come, but if you decide to make Christ your head, you'll be able to the rock. And so as you light this unity candle, your individual agenda is no more. Your own fleshly desires are no more. But it is the will of God that shall reign. And just before the night, I would like for the families of the bride and groom to stand. Because it's not just Larry and our sheep. It's the Jackson and Mitchell family. And I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you would lovingly, charitably, learn to mind your own business. In Jesus' name.
Mr. and Mrs. Larry and I, Sheba Jackson.